Hey guys, welcome back to another very exciting tutorial of Creatnprocess. I'm really making this another very cool logo design. This logo has got a very unique shape. It's three-dimensional view. It's represented with the help of a few shades of color. So to create this logo, we'll first use the rectangle tool to create a square, and with the help of extrude bevel option, we'll be creating a cuboid like this to ensure the basic structure of this design. Then with the help of symbol, which we'll be creating with the help of square, and that will include 3x3 division, we'll add up that in each surfaces, and then we'll expand it with the help of object expand option, and then we'll do little tweaking like arrangement of all the faces in the proper places, and we will add up the color and the text. So let's begin the tutorial. So first let's select the rectangle tool and left click your mouse button. Here keep the width and height around 100, maybe any, but it should be constant, and click OK. And after that, I'll fill this up with certain light color like white, and I keep it here. Now next thing is I'll use the 3D extrude and bevel option to create a cube. So I'll preview it like this, and after that I'll keep the extrude depth 100 points. Make sure you put the same value which you put earlier for the square, that's 100, I have putting 100. Then after that I'll go in here and I'll select isometric right, and this will bring this surface. I need this face, and click, and after that I'll just make sure this is wireframe for now and click OK. Now next thing is we'll prepare a shape. So we'll, with the help of rectangle tool, we'll create one more square. It should be 100 by 100, and click OK. And after that I'll go to object path and split into grid, and make sure rows and columns are 3x3. We need 3x3 columns like this. Change the value and click OK. So it will divide into 3x3 columns. Now next thing is we'll fill this up with different shades of color. So I'm selecting this with a shift press, just select all the corners and change the colors to something else. I'm taking red, and center one I'll change it to something different like this. Now select everything, and here's the symbol option. So I'll just click and drag it to the symbol box here and drop it there. And the symbol option will appear, give a name, plus I'll give pulse, P-U-L-S-E, pulse, or maybe yes, okay, and click OK. So this is now the symbol. You can delete it from here. Now next thing is I'll select this, and I'll go to the parameters of this. So I'll go to Windows and Appearance, and here you got that parameters, 3D Extrude and Bevel option. I'll just go in there, preview it, and I'll just make sure it's plastic shaded. And I'll go in here, map art, and under map art, make sure we will be selecting only three faces, this, this, and this. This time this is the face, so I'll just bring in that pulse. Next I'll click here and it will transfer to the next face, but it's the back side, so I don't need that. And this is the back, this is the down, and this is the front. I'll put one more pulse here, and on the top one more. So I'll just click pulse and click OK. Now after that just click OK. So you can see we have created a nice cube. Now next thing is we'll expand this. Go to object, expand appearance, go to object, expand, and ungroup it for tries, I think. OK, now everything is separate. Now release clipping mask, select this, release clipping mask, select this, release clipping mask, and in this way we are separated all the stuff which are in the background. You can just select everything and delete it out. Now our object is only object. Now I'll just go in there and group it, and each faces are now separate. Now next thing is we'll just make sure these faces are one object. So I'll just select these and this and combine it. So I'll go to Pathfinder and just combine. In the same way, I'll select this and this and just combine it. This one, this one, this one, this, and this, combine it. So this is plus, the rest different. So I'll just make sure I need these corners to be deleted out. So I'll just select this, delete this corner, delete this corner, delete. So we are left with only these pieces. Now next thing is we'll just fill this up with certain colors so that we can distinguish the faces. So I'll just select this face, and this face, and with the eye picker just select this color, select this color, and we can select these corner pieces separately, and with the R picker select the dark color like that so that we can distinguish it. In the same way, I select this R picker, select this color and select these corner pieces and select the color darker one. In the same way, select this with the R picker, it's white, it's okay. Select this, this and this. Let's change it to something else for a while, like light. Now let's reposition it. Now if you see here, the two faces are here and down is flat. But here the two faces are down and top, flat is on top. So we'll just select all the three pieces and with the shift press just rotate it to almost 180 degree and place it there. Now next thing is, we'll do something here, we'll do little adjustment, like I'll just move this a little bit aside and this one, just drag this down like this. So select this, select and drag it down until it attaches there. In the same way, I'll just select this and drag it here and place it in the proper place. And select this one, and arrange it to front. In the same way, select this piece, arrange it to front so that we need this all the front. So arrange it to front. Now select this piece, move it aside, select this, drag it down and place it in the proper place. Now select this and drag it there and place it there. In the same way, select this piece, move it aside, select this, drag and place it there. In the same way, select this, drag, place it there. So let's zoom it in and check it out whether we have placed it properly. Zoom it in, okay, this one, we need a little adjustment like that. The same way, go in here, I think we have left a little space. Like this, so we need to zoom it in and make sure it's correctly placed in the proper places like this. You can see corners are not joined properly, so just zoom in and place it there like this. Same way, let's see this corner. I think this corner is fine. Select this, see here whether it's good. Okay, we need to do a little adjustment here. We see a gap in between that, so just place it there. Okay, that's fine. So in this way, we have to zoom it in and do all the necessary stuff. I'll just scale this up a little bit and zoom, select everything, scale with the shift and alt press, just scale it up. I'll just scale this on a little bit like that. And now let's fill up the proper color. This one is good. This one, select this, this, this. With the R picker, select the color. Let's see the different, this one is correct. This one is the correct color. So we have filled up with all the required colors and now it's looking good. Now the last thing which we are left here is the text. So let's type a text. T is the shortcut for text. Click here. Let's switch on the caps lock, P-U-L-S-E pulse, and I'll switch off the caps lock. Now I'll just select this, and the font which we're using here is Microsoft E-Better. So you can just select that and type it out here and you will find it here. So we have applied that, and after that we'll go to character and keep the distance around 800 and the font size around 30 or 1 or maybe 32 like that, and place it in their proper place. So I'll just place it there. Make sure the color, so I'll just with the R picker just select the color from here, darker tone like that, and we can give little spacing like this. So we'll go to character and let's increase the spacing 850. Let's check it out. Okay, that's good, and place it in the proper place. So finally we have created the logo. We have used this very unique tricks and created this complex design in a very simpler steps. Hope you enjoyed the tutorial. Don't forget to check out the next tutorial coming up. And if you want more updates on designing, you can press the subscribe button. Thank you.